Today, we are going to start a topic named Sequence and Series. It's required in all of the boards for class 11. So, we'll talk about the sequence part of it today, like your sequence, AP, GP, that part. Okay, so now what is a sequence? The first thing that comes to mind is, suppose you go to a bank and you deposit money like every once in a while. Like, aaj kar rahe ho, do din baad kuch kiya, and then another day. Like, suppose you gave 500 in the first day, a few days later, if we give 1000, another few days later, we give 8000, a few days later, 700, and this goes on like. This is what a sequence looks like. It doesn't have to have common difference or common ratio. ऐसा नहीं होना है कि पांच ही बढ़ रहा है कि दस ही बढ़ रहा है कि दस ही कम रहा है division plus minus ऐसा होना है ऐसा कोई बात नहीं. That is done in a collection, like बहुत बार हो रहा है, that is called a sequence. Alright, so here it is a sequence. इधर में कोई particular gap नहीं है, like 500 से 1000, 1000 से 8000, 8000 से 7000, not this is a sequence. Now what comes of it is sequence को हम डिनोट कैसे करते हैं, नोटेशन क्या है सीक्वेंस का. अ सीक्वेंस इज नोटेड बाय ए वन इन फॉर सेकंड ब्रैकेट कर्ली ब्रैकेट्स वी राइट इट एज ए वन कॉमा ए टू कॉमा ए थ्री कॉमा डॉट डॉट ए एन. नाउ यू नो द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फाइनाइट एंड इनफाइनाइट. Finite, if there are finite elements in sequence, then it will go on from 1 to A1 to AN. And if there are infinite number of terms, then it goes like A1, A2, A3, dot 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 AN, then it goes on. This is the whole notation form. Or we can write this as just this. Either is okay. Now, we are gonna do the first sum related to this topic. We are given a certain value. It's a AN equals to 1 by 3 whole. This is the sequence given. Now, we have to find the first 5 terms of it. How will we find it? In putting N equals to, we are going to find the first 5 times, right? Five terms, right? So, all we have to do is put the value of 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 in N. So, we are going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now what happens doing this is A1, we are putting the value of 1 first. So what's going to happen is we are putting the value of 1, A1 is going to come equals to 1 by 3 whole. 3 n is given, so 3 into 1 minus 4. What is the value of it? 1 by 3 whole, 3 minus 4. That is 1 by 3 whole minus 1. And since bracket is given, it's in multiplication. So the value that is going to come is minus 1 by 3. This is the value of the first term. Now the second term, we are going to do it in a similar format. It's going to be 1 by 3 whole 3 into 2 minus 4. So what's going to become? 6 minus 4. It's going to be 1 minus 3 into 2. That is going to be 2 by 3. In a similar format, A3 is going to be 5 by 3. Going on in the same format, the next results become A4 equals to 1 by 3 whole 3 into 4 minus 4, which is going to be 8 by 3. And the last one, the fifth term, is going to be A5 equals to 1 by 3 whole 3 into 5 minus 4. That's going to be 1 by 3, 15 minus 4. 1 by 3 into 11, that's going to be 11 by 3. Now, we have got the first five terms, because that is what asked in the question. Now, if the question asks that we want another few of the terms, then we'll find another few and give dot 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 with respect. But we don't want, here we want only the first 5 terms. So, this is the pattern that is going to be followed. Now, the final thing that we'll write down is, therefore, the first 5 terms of AN are minus 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 5 by 3, 8 by 3 and 11 by 3. We are now given the part, like we have to find the corresponding series. So first of all, before finding the corresponding series, we have to know what a series is. If A1, A2, A3, dot dot dot, AN forms a sequence, series is gonna be, series is generally denoted by SN. So how we'll write down series? It's gonna be the addition of all the terms of sequence. First you have to find a sequence, and if the terms of the sequence when added form a series. So it's gonna be A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus dot 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 plus AN. This is gonna be a series. So we have here, we have found the numbers which are in the sequence. Now we have to find the corresponding series. What does corresponding mean? Corresponding means the series side by side. For this term, set of terms, what is the series that's gonna be formed? The series, therefore, the corresponding series is gonna be this one plus the second term plus the third term plus the fourth term plus the fifth term. Now, in this case scenario, what is gonna happen? If there were infinite number of terms, we would have given a plus and another few, and then we have given dot dot dot. Since there are only 5 terms over here, we are going to do the addition of 5 terms. We don't need to write the value of it. It's not certainly required. All we have to do is write it in this format. Find out the terms of the sequence and write out in the addition format. This is the given sum, right? Now what we are going to do is, we are going to first turn it. 1 by u n plus 1. We are going to turn it. What's going to happen? It's going to be a reciprocal. The reciprocal of this is 1 plus 2 un by un. The answer that comes is 1 by un plus 2. This is the format that is coming. For n equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Why are we doing this? You will see. For 1, u1 it's already given. When n is 1, then what is going to come? 1. Now 1 by 1 plus 1 is there, so 1 by u1 plus 2. Okay, so we can also write it in this format. 1 by u1 plus 2 into 1. Okay, now the second one that we are going to do is, we are going to put the value 2. u2 plus 1. Then what's happening is going to be 1 by u2 plus 2. That's going to be 1 by u1. Now we are going to put the value of 1 by u2 over here. What is the value of 1 by u2? The value of 1 by u2 is this one, plus 2 into 1. And also plus 2 is already given over here, so we'll write plus 2. Right? For the value is going to come as 1 by u1 plus 2 into 2. Since there is 1 2 over here and another 2 over here, so both of them become 4, that we can say 2 into 2. We are writing it in this format. It becomes 1 by u3. So u3 plus 1 is gonna be 1 by, we are going to put the value 3 over here. So what happens if we put 3 over here? The sum becomes 1 by u3 plus 2. 1 by u3 plus 2. 1 by u3, what is the value of 1 by u3? We got 1 by u1 plus 2 into 2. 1 by u1 plus 2 into 2. And already 2 is given. So what does this value come up, sum up to? u1 plus 2 into 3. Is it not? Now see, from this we find the pattern. What pattern do we find? If we go on like this, dot dot dot. If we go on like this, we find a certain pattern. What pattern do we find? We find that 1 by u n plus 1 is equals to 1 by u1 plus 2 into n. That we can simplify and write it in this format, 2n. This is the format that we gain from here. So now what do we have to do? We have to find, the question is given, we have to find the value of u96. We have to find the value of u96. First, putting the values n equals to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Or 1, 2, 3 just over here in this case. U1 is already given. U2, U3, U4. We found the values of this. This is U4, 1 by U4. Found the values of this. Now, what is going to happen? We are going to find a certain formula for it. We found this formula for it. Now, we are going to write down putting n equals to 95. Since we want the value of 96, we are going to put 95. Because putting 95 over here, 95 plus 1 becomes 96. So what are we going to write down it as? 1 by u 95 plus 1 equals to, that's going to come 1 by u 1 plus 2 into 95. That's going to be 1 by u 96 equals to 1 by u 1 plus 190. Now the value of this, we're going to write down it as 1 by u 96 equals to 1 by u 1 becomes, since u 1's value is given 1 by 2, we have written it down in the first part, u 1 is given 1 by 2. Now 1 by u 1, that's the reciprocal of it. What the value is going to be? 2 plus 190. Now this implies 1 by u 96, now if you do the reciprocal of it, u 96 becomes 1 by 192, and hence this is our answer. Now we are going to do another sum, but all of them are a bit different from each other. We did two sums, one we did the basic, the first one we did the basic, this one we did it, it was a bit tricky. We are going to do the third part, which is going to be a slight different from the first two parts. For the third one, it's given, so basic, as how I have taught in the previous two sums, we have to do is putting n equals to, we have to find the first 5 terms, we'll put n equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll put this, and what happens accordingly is u1 equals to minus 1 to the power 1 into 1 by 3 into 1 plus 1, which becomes minus 1 into 1 by 3 plus 1. That becomes minus 1 by 4. Now, accordingly, if we do u2, it shows minus 1 to the power 2 into 1 by 3 into 2 plus 1, which equals to minus 1 whole square becomes positive. So, it's not going to show up over here. It's going to be 1 by 6 plus 1, which is going to be 1 by 7. Next one comes u3 equals to minus 1 whole cube into 1 by 3 into 3 plus 1. Now, cube of any negative term, the answer always becomes minus. Now, 1 by 3 into 3, 9 plus 1, that's going to be minus 1 by 10. And accordingly, u4 is going to be minus 1 to the power 4 into 1 by 3 into 4 plus 1. That's going to be, since it's the power is, the negative is to the power of an even number, it becomes positive. And what it's going to be is 12 plus 1, it's going to be 1 by 13. And the last one, since they have asked us to find the only 5 terms, we are going to do, this is going to be the last one. We are going to do u minus 1 to the power 5 into 1 by 3 into 5 plus 1, which becomes to the power of, if we raise a negative number to the power of 5, that is an odd number, it becomes negative. The answer comes as 10 plus 1. That is going to be minus 1 by 11. Now, since we have found our first 5 terms, we are going to write it down as, therefore, the first 5 terms are, what are the 5 terms? The first term is minus 1 by 4, 1 by 7, minus 1 by 10, 1 by 13, and 1 by 11. Sorry. It comes 15. 15 are there. I'm sorry about it. 16. So it becomes 16. 1 by 16. Okay. So, and there is a second part to it. The second question comes is find the corresponding series. Now, how we have to find the corresponding series? You know it very well. All we have to do is we have found the terms of the sequence, the first 5 terms, and corresponding series is 5 terms ke liye. We have to find the corresponding series. What's going to be? It's going to be like the 5 terms added up. It's going to be the corresponding series. 1 by 4 plus, that is minus 1 by 4. We'll write down it in a bracket. By 1 by 7 plus minus 1 by 10. So this is the corresponding series. If this is not negative, what does it state? Saying ki, it's given an has to be non-negative. It means an cannot be less than 0. Right? What does it mean? It states that an has to be either greater than 0 or equal to 0, which means we put the value of an, it's given over here, n cube, minus n square minus 5n minus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. We have to do midterm factorization. We'll do it like minus 3, minus 3n, minus 2n. It's gonna be minus 2n square plus n square n cube. This is gonna be the factorization. Greater than or equal to 0. Now we have to take in the common parts, n plus 1 minus 2n. If we take common, it's gonna come n plus 1. Again, minus 3 if we take common, it's gonna come n plus 1. Greater than or equal to. Now the next part is n square minus 2n minus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. Which, in regarding, if this is again factorized in the middle, we have to do another midterm factorization. Now, n plus 1, it is as it is, we do is n square minus 3n plus n minus 3. Now, n plus 1, by taking n common, this is what it's left out, and taking 1 common, n minus 3 is left. Now, we'll take n minus 3 common over here. Taking n minus 3 common, what is left out? N plus 1. So, we can see it comes to n plus 1 whole square and n minus 3. In the first case scenario, n plus 1 equals to 0, which comes to n equals to minus 1. And the second case scenario, n minus 3 is greater than or equal to 0, which comes to n is greater than or equals to 3. Now, in both cases, it is stated that n minus 1 is, n is either greater than or equal to minus 1, and it's also stated n is greater than or equal to 3. Now, tell me, if something in the number line, suppose this is minus 1, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If something is greater than minus 1 and something is also greater than 3, here if we intersect both of this, this totally implies that the thing has to be greater than 3. Minus 1 se bhi zyada hai, 3 se bhi zyada hai. Dono ko mila ke 3 se hi to zyada hai. So this finally results that n has to be greater than or equal to 3. Now the question asks is the least number, the least positive number for which ye wala non-negative hoga. So this is coming non-negative for which value of n? The least value is 3, because if it was greater than 3, it would have been 4. But it is said greater than equal to 3. Thus the value comes to 3. Therefore the least value of n is, hence this is the answer. Now we go by arithmetic progression. Now we have learned sequence. Now from sequence, how do we know what a progression is? Sequence and progressions are not exactly the same. Not all sequence is progression. Every progression is sequence, but not all sequence is progression. Sequences, as I have told, ki when we do a collective number of things, that is sequence. Suppose we are giving money in the bank, we are depositing money for 2 years, 3 years, we go on like doing that, right? Like in a year we have gone maybe 36, 37 number of times. So the however money we have deposited, 500, 600, 700 or 1000 or again 100, however we have deposited the money, that forms a sequence. But for progression, what happens in progression? A sequence with a specific pattern is called a progression. So what happens? A sequence, suppose here 500 pichle first din we are depositing in the bank, 100 in the second day, third day 1000, then it comes 800. Now this sequence, if we go on by this sequence doesn't follow a specific pattern. The decrease of amount here is 400. The increase of amount is 900. Again, the decrease is 2150. So here it's not constant. So what will happen is, this doesn't form a progression. For a sequence to become a progression, it has to be and must to be like, it has to have a specific pattern. For example, I bought 2 chocolates today. For the next day, I have to buy 4 chocolates. The next day, if I buy 6 chocolates, and then again the next day, 8 chocolates. And if this goes by accordingly, what happens is the increases by 2. It's increasing by 2 in each case scenario. Hence, it follows a specific pattern and therefore it becomes a progression. And it can also be like this. Suppose I bought 99 dresses, suppose, for example, today. And the next day, I'm buying 33 dresses. Again, the next day, I'm buying 11 dresses. Now, how does it follow a specific pattern? In the first case, we are dividing by 1 by 3. In the next case also, we are dividing by 1 by 3. What occurs over here is, it follows a specific pattern. Hence, sequence that we are following becomes a progression.
Okay.
Now, since we will discuss with arithmetic progression over here, what we will take into consideration is only the first part, the addition and the subtraction part. Not the division and the multiplication. That part is geometric progression. So, we will deal with increment and decrement of. Now, over here, in the 2, 6, 8 only, 2, 4, 6, 8, how much is it increasing? By 2 we are increasing, right? The increment is by 2 and hence goes forward. If this we take into consideration, the first term, normally the terms are known as A1, A2, A3, A4, dot, dot, dot. As you know, as I have talked. But in this case, also with this, the first term is considered to be A. You can say A1 as well as the A1, A2, A3, A4 is generally referred to the whole terms. Now, if we only are talking about the first term, we can refer it to as A. If we are talking about this N, suppose it ends over at 64, suppose. So, if this is the last term, it's a finite sequence, and if this is the last term, if it's infinite, then I can't say where it goes. But if it's finite and suppose it goes till 64, if we take, what we will say A1, A2, A3, this suppose for a certain value, it will turn A64, A something, AN, right? And this is the last term, right? So, A1, A2, A3, A4, as a thing, this becomes AN, some number. But normally, generally, when we are dealing with an AP, we call, say, the first term to be A, suppose, and the last term to be L. According to what we are saying, first term A, last term L. Now, the common difference is 2 over here. How are we finding the common difference? The increment is 2. If it was decrement, suppose we have started with 16, then it comes 8, then it comes 0, then what is occurring? It's like minus 8 is happening. Then suppose minus 8, so the decrement of minus 8 is going on, the decrement of 8. So what happens here, the first term is A and the last term is L. Okay, and the common difference is minus 8, since we are decreasing by minus. So accordingly, we will do a few sums over here and series remains quite the same. All we have to find out all the terms of the AP and then write it in an addition format. If we write it as that, we form a series. And the series is called, since the progression is called arithmetic progression, the series is called arithmetic series as well, correspondingly. Okay, now the general formulas of an AP. For a general formula, with a given A is the first term, and a given D is the common difference between two APs. How can we, how do we write the general formula? We write it as AN equals to A plus N minus 1 whole D, where suppose we'll find out the fifth term. If we want to find the fifth term, we know the A value, the first value of it. We'll put down this value, we'll put down the value of D, and here we'll write 5 minus 1. Okay? The corresponding whatever we need to find respectively, we have to put and provided we know the value of A and D. Okay? Now this is the general formula. And there is also another formula, which is the sum of the series. If we want to find the sum of an AP, there is an arithmetic progression, like the sequence goes on and we want to find the sum. Suppose the sequence goes at 1, A1, A2, A3, A4, as a AN tak jata hai, then how will we find the sum of an AP? So first n terms, these are the first n terms. So first term is A1, second term is A2, third term is A3, and respectively nth term is AN. If you want to find the first addition of the first n terms, we'll write it as, it is denoted as SN. And we write it as n by 2, this is the formula, n by 2 whole 2a plus n minus 1 whole d. This is the formula. And sometimes it is also written as this, but this is done only in the case of the, if we know here we need the value that is provided is A and D, we will be provided with. But in case if we know the first term A and the last term and we don't know the D, the common difference, then the another formula, another way that we can use this formula is A plus N. This formula can only be used in case of no if we are provided with the values of A and L. And this can be used in case of if we are provided the values of A and D. Alright. The first sum that we are going to do is very basic. This, these three are provided. We have to prove that these three are an AP. Now, how will we do that? The value is given. The first term is given x square plus 2xy minus y square and whole square of that. The value here comes to, we'll follow the formula. We had learned it in when we are very young. Hopefully, you people remember it. The formula is a plus b plus c whole square equals to a square plus b square plus c square. The square of the individual terms, the first three, then it becomes 2 whole ab plus bc plus ca. Now, this is the formula that we are going to follow in this one and in the next one as well. Because the next one is the same type of, the term is the same type of the same type. Okay. Now, what we are going to do is, the value comes to over here, it comes to the first term square is x to the power 4, second term square is 4, x square, y square, and the third term that is minus y square, that its square is plus y to the power 4. Now, 2 whole, multiplication of the first two terms, it comes to 2x cube y, then the multiplication of the second and the third term, that comes to 2xy cube, and the multiplication of the third and the first term, that comes to minus x square y square, and that individually comes to x to the power 4 plus y to the power 4 and plus 4x cube y plus 4, sorry, minus 4xy cube, and if we do the sum over here, 2 into minus x square y square and 4x square y square, that comes to 2x square y square. Now, this is the first term. So, the second term is given as x square plus y square whole square. That forms x to the, this is a very basic formula used. We have learned this very young. A plus b whole square. X to the power 4 plus x to the y to the power 4 plus 2x square y square. And the last term is given a3 equals to x square minus 2xy minus y square whole square. Now this comes as x to the power 4 plus a square plus b square. B square becomes minus 2xy becomes 4x square y square. Then c square minus y square becomes y to the power 4 plus 2 whole ab. Ab becomes minus 2x cube y. BC, that becomes plus 2xy cube, and CA becomes minus x square y square. That falls to x to the power 4 plus y to the power 4 minus 4x cube y minus 4 plus 4xy cube. And here 4x square y square and minus 2x square y square becomes plus 2x square y square. Now this is the whole of the first three terms. Now the three terms are given. We have found out the value. We have simplified it. We have to show it. These three are in AP. The easiest way to show something is in AP, we have to show that they have a specific pattern to them and they have an increment or a decrement by a certain number. They are increased or decreased by a certain number. So here we have to subtract the first two and then the second two, and if we find a similar pattern, a similar number used in increasing or decreasing in the increment or decrement in both the terms, then it forms an AP. So what we will do is over here, we will do is minus the first term from the second term, so A2 minus A1, that will become as, if you minus these two terms, it will become minus 4x cube y plus 4xy cube, and these two are going to cancel each other. So this is only left. These and these are going to cancel each other in the subtraction, and these two will be only left. Now that is what happens in case of a1, a2 minus a1. In case of a3 minus a2, what will happen? We will subtract it. What is left out? Only minus 4x cube y plus 4xy cube. these are left out. If you follow, if you simplify it correctly and if you do the sums correctly as well, the answer is going to come to this in both the cases. And since we can see both of these subtractions have the same value, the difference is the same, and we can say that the whole thing forms a 18. Therefore, since, first we write since A3 minus A2 is equal to A2 minus A1, we can say A1, A2, A3 form an AP. Or the better way to write is x square minus xy, 2xy, sorry, plus x square plus 2xy minus y square, comma, x square plus y square whole square, comma, x square minus 2xy minus y square form an AP. If TR is the rth term of an AP, TN is the mth term of an AP, and TN is the nth term of an AP. So how will we deal with this part? We have to solve this first part. So M in the brackets, TM, what does TM mean? A plus M minus 1 into D equals to N whole A plus N minus 1 whole D. This means this. If we multiply AM plus M whole M minus 1 whole D equals to N whole A plus N minus 1 into D minus AN equals to N whole N minus 1 D minus M whole M minus 1 D. Now, if we write it properly, V square minus N whole D minus M square minus M plus M D. This becomes this. We can take this part common. How will we take this part common? We can write it as M square minus N square. So if we take A common, M minus N is happening. Over here, if we take what is happening, N whole N minus 1 minus M whole M minus 1. This is the simplification. A whole M minus N equals to D whole. It becomes N square minus N minus M square plus N. Right? Now, after doing this, we have to do midterm factorizing. Minus whole M square minus N square. Okay. So, A whole M minus N equals to D. From here it comes 1 minus M square minus N square. Say if we take M minus N out, what is left? M plus N is left. Can we cancel M plus N, M minus N on both sides? If we cancel M minus N on both sides, we have to write down a certain thing. We have to write down in bracket M minus N not equal to 0. Which means M cannot be equal to N. Since we are cancelling M minus N on both sides, we have to write it down beside. Minus, we will just take this one on this side. A minus D whole 1 minus M plus N equal to 0. Arrange it in the proper order and therefore our answer will be there. A plus D whole. We will take the minus inside, so what will happen? Minus 1 plus M minus M plus N will be there. This is T, since we are using T over here. Sometimes we use A to represent an AP, AN, or A, sometimes we use UN. Here we are using TN to represent an AP. So this will become TM plus N equals to 0. See, for TM plus N, we have to prove A plus the number minus 1 whole D. So reversely, this is the proof that is required, and hence we have done it. So, proved. Now, in the question, it's given that the series is this one. 27 plus 24 plus 21 dot dot dot. And it said, the sum of certain n numbers, suppose it's 132. We have to find out how many number of terms are to be added to get 132. We have to do two things. First, the series is this one. So, from here we find out the first term. Here, what is the first term? The first term is 27. And we have to find out the common difference. The basic two things required to find anything in AP. The D is, it's going to be 24 minus the second one minus the first one. First one, it becomes the common difference, that is minus 3 over here. We have found the first term and the common difference. Now, over here, it is said Sn equals to 132. Sum of certain n numbers is 132. We have to find out how many numbers. So, can we write it down like this? This one, Sn equals to 132 means n by 2, right? 2a plus n minus 1 over d equals to 132, which in turn means n by 2, 2a, here the a is 27, 2 into 27 plus n minus 1, we don't know how many numbers, we don't know the value of n, we have to find it out. So d is also, we have found out it earlier, so minus 3, we have to do n by 2, now 2 into 27 is 54 plus, now it's n minus 1 into minus 3. So what will happen over here? Minus 3 whole n minus 1 equals to 132. We can write it in like this, 54 minus 3n plus 3. Just we are multiplying it and opening the bracket, 132 n by 2. 54 plus 3, it comes to 57 minus 3n equals to 132. Division on one side of equal to means multiplication on another side. So this becomes 57 minus 3n, and the 2 division over here becomes multiplication on that side, 132 into 2. So this comes to 57n minus 3n square equals to 4. 319. So we can take 3 in common over here. Now 3 we can take in common on both sides, and we can cancel this 3 out. Now the equation is much smaller and it's easier to solve. Now all you have to do is solve this by midterm factorization. How will we solve this? We can just expand it in this format. Minus 11n minus 8n plus 88 equal to 0. We'll take n common and n minus 11 will come, and minus 8 common, so n minus 11 will again come, equal to 0, and hence we will get two values of n, 8 and 11. Now what is happening is, the sum is not that difficult. What the twist is, we are finding two values. So hereby the concept becomes key for two values of n, suppose for 8 terms also, for 11 terms also, if we add up to first 8 terms, if we add the first 8 terms, it's coming 132, and even also if we add the first 11 terms, it's also coming 132. Now both can't happen simultaneously. So there is some like contradictory statement, so we have to find out. Here in the question, it is also said that explain why the double answer. So we'll now try to explain the double answer, okay? Okay, now for the first, n is given 8, also n is given 11. So now according conceptually, it says ki for 8 terms also, if we add up the first 8 terms, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. First 8 terms, it will also come 132. And this one says, if we add up the first 11 terms, it will also come to 132. So how will we, so here we have to just check whether it's true or not. Now we know the first term is 27 and the common difference is minus 3. So we follow the format as usual. If the first term is 27, we'll write 27 in the first one, and the second term will be minus 3. So 24, again it will be 21, next one will be 18, next one 15, next one 12, and then again 9, and then it comes to 6. So if we add all these, we'll get 132. Okay, for the next one, let's see for the 11 terms. So let's do 27, 24, 21, 18, 15, 12, 9, 6, and minus 3 once again. So 3, minus 3 once again, so 0, and another minus 3, so minus 3. Now, we can clearly see where the twist occurs. So here what happens, if we add all the 8 terms, this will be the value. And similarly here, if we add the 11 terms, what happens is here 3 and minus 3 cancel each other. And 0 has no value in that case scenario. So this is the actually the only terms that are being added. So it's similar to the adding of the 8 terms. So basically it states ki 8 and 11 both have the same value in this sense. It makes sense only in this kind of way. So here we find the explanation for our answer. Why the double answer? And in question, if it comes in this format, we have to mention, we have to show this and say, for this reason, since here 3 and minus 3 cancel each other, for this reason, the answer occurs like there are two answers for the given sum. Okay, so the next question, it's a bit tricky. Again, like the previous one. So what it says over here, okay, this is the sequence given. It is given in the question, this is the sequence, and we have to add the number of terms 2n plus 1, we have to add it up till this term. Alright, so we have to add the whole sequence up to 2n plus 1 terms. So can we write it in a series format? Can we write it in this format, in the series? Like, can we write it in addition format? Since we have to add it up, it means series, so we have to, can we write in this format? So what happens is, all the terms are added up to 2n minus 1 terms. Now, if you see here, if you observe it a bit, what happens is, you will find it isn't a sequence. It isn't a proper sequence. If we look at it, does it form any kind of sequence? No. What we have to do over here is, there are two sequences involved and woven within each other. We have to separate those two sequences. What we'll do is, we first take the first order sequence, 2, 5, 2, 5, 8, 11. This is the first order sequence. And the second sequence is 3, 9, 15, 21. If you observe it a bit carefully, you will see here 3 is the common difference and over here 6 is the common difference. So we are separating two sequences out of one sequence. Also, it is said that 2n plus 1 terms are needed to be added, right, over here. So what we will do is, we will add up the first part. Let's add up the first part of it. 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11. And now the big question is, till how many terms will we add only one half of the sequence? One half of the sequence is 2, 5, 8, 11, and till how much will it go? Because together both of them will go up to 2n plus 1 terms. And individually, we have to find out how much will this go. For now, let it be blank. Let us add the next part. The next part is 3 plus 9 plus 15 plus 21. Plus dot dot dot. We can clearly see it's a 6, a common difference 6 vala situation, and either way it is a 3 vala situation. So equal to dash terms. Both of the sequence together, they go up to 2n plus 1 terms. Now individually, the first sequence, it will go up to how many terms, and second one how many terms, so that both of them together form 2n plus 1 terms. Now how will we find this out? Just think about it. The first number is the first sequence and the second one is the second sequence. Again, first sequence, second sequence. So it goes on in this order. First sequence, second sequence. First sequence, second sequence. First sequence, second sequence. Since we are adding up to 2n plus 1 terms and 2n plus 1 is itself an odd term, so the last term of the whole addition, of the whole series, the last term will be an odd term, and in the odd position, which terms are there? First sequence is in the odd position. Which are the odd terms? This is the first term, this is the third term, this is the sixth term, and over here, these terms are of the first sequence. The first sequence will land up in the last, right? So the first sequence will have n plus 1 number of terms, and the second sequence, which have the even number of sets, they will add the second sequence, this one, 3, 9, 15, 21, because they are in the even slot, they will have n terms. Alright, now what we will do is, we will add it up. In the first case scenario, what will happen, this will happen, the A is over here, is the formula for this one. Okay, let's name it as such, let Sn equals to 2 plus Sn plus 1 be 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11 plus dot 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 n 1 n plus 1 terms, and Tn equals to 3 plus 9 plus 15 plus 21 plus n terms. Let us consider this. Now what we'll do is, In the first case scenario, letters for SN, for SN, can, what is the first term? The first term is 2. And what is the common difference? The common difference is 3. It increases by 3. Right? So, how will we find SN in this case? SN plus 1 in this case? Sorry, case of SN plus 1. How will we find SN plus 1 in this case? We find N by 2. And over here, what is N? N is N plus 1. So, N plus 1 by 2 in bracket 2A plus N minus 1. What is N over here? N plus 1 minus 1. That's the formula. Bracket D. How will we find this out? N plus 1 by 2 bracket 2A. 2A means A is 2 given. So, it becomes 4 plus either it becomes N, D is 3. So, this is the formula up till now. The formula is N plus 1, 4 plus 3 N by 2. The value of which is 1 by 2 bracket 4 N plus 3 N plus, okay, let's do it in one more. 4 N plus 3 N square plus 4 plus 3, which becomes 1 by 2. 3n square plus 7n plus 4. This is the first term. The first addition. The addition of the first sequence. Series. The first series. And for the second series, what we are going to do is, we find out a and b as well. For tn, we see a is 3. In the second series, we are talking about the second series. Now, first series sn, we did it. The second series, what happens is, a's value is 3 and b's value is 6. The series goes, if you don't remember, it goes like 3, 6, 9, 15, dot, dot, dot. It goes like this. So, in this case, what happens is the A is 3, the B is 6. Now, what we'll find out is Tn, the addition. What is the formula? N by 2. Over here, N is N only. So, N by 2 bracket 2A plus N minus 1 whole D. Now, what will be the value? N by 2 bracket 2a means 6 plus n minus 1 whole d means 6. So, if we just multiply it, let's do it. Okay, n whole bracket 3 plus n minus 1 whole 3. This becomes. Okay, now, so what happens over here is n whole 3 plus n minus 3. 3n minus 3. So, what does it become? It cancels out and it becomes 3n square. Now, if we revert back to the former sequence, it divides into these two parts and we have to find the addition of both. And in the first case, we got the value Sn. It becomes 1 by 2 whole 3n square plus 7n plus 4. This was the value of the first addition. This is the addition of the first sequence, which is the first series that we got Sn. The second one is Tn, the sum of the second sequence, the second series. The value here comes 3n square. Now, if we could just do the LCM, what comes up is 7n plus 4 plus, okay, if we do the LCM over here, 2, 3, 6n square by 2. And hence the answer comes 1 by 2, 3n, 6n, 9n square plus 7n plus 4. This is the answer.